together for Darren Criss.
Such a welcome party of Melbourne. Thank
nice God. To have you back. Hey, just to kick off, the SAG-AFTRA strike is still ongoing, so we can't talk about your film or acting work, but you're here to talk about your music anyway.
Yeah, you don't want to talk about stuff anyway. It's
boring. Really? Yeah. Crowds love you. What's it like to perform in front of them so far?
Well, Australia has been such a huge support system for a lot of the stuff that I've been involved with for well over a decade, and it's been really a shame that it's taken me so long to finally get here. It is an awful long distance for us Yanks to get out here. So we finally are here, and hopefully I'm making up for some lost time. And I feel very much the hose has been held for so long that getting to be with a lot of these folks in Australia that have been following my stuff, again, for over a decade, I've kind of watched them almost... They've watched me grow up, I've watched them grow up. Getting to spend a bit of time with them in person and really just thank them for what they've done for me has been just such a joy. I'm just so happy to be here.
So you mentioned the last decade of your career. The set list is kind of spanning, you know, that whole time. Mm-hmm. How do you pick the things you want to play? Is it for the crowd or is it for you?
No, it's for the crowd. I like to say that I'm in the service industry. I'm not there for me. Like, I am here for other people. I am just a vessel to make sure that you have a good time, and if I fall short of that, then that's on me. But no, it's hard, man. It's hard to pick songs. I mean, every show's different, so sometimes there's a lot of stuff from TV stuff I've done and theater stuff I've done, songs that I've written, stuff for musicals that I've written, and the genres are all over the place, but I try to give something for everybody. But because I'm in Australia and your guys' musical legacy is so insanely good, trying to pick what Aussie songs I play each show, because I do a different one. Yeah. I'm on stage in like a half hour, and I have to learn a new song every night, so I have to do that from now. If you're watching this and you're coming to see me, just know that I haven't learned what I'm going to do yet. But well, you guys have so many great bands and artists that have come through here. Melbourne has a lot.
Yeah.
Kylie, obviously.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Jet is from
Harry Styles sang a bit of Daryl Braithwaite Horses when he was.
Wow. Yeah. Okay, that's a nice. That's okay. So cross that off the list. Doing what Harry does. But no, it's a huge list. So just it kind of has to do with what I don't know, any requests. What should I play? What should I?
Well, we've been talking a lot about You're the Voice this week, and that's quite John Farnham.
That's a good one, yeah.
Yeah.
Also, I mean, the other Darren, the other famous Darren of Australia,
Mr. Andy Hayes Savage Garden.
Yeah. I'm away from Sydney because I know I think he's a Sydney guy.
Isn't he Brisbane?
Oh, he's Brisbane. Oh, I screwed that up. I'm so sorry. But that's a bit closer, I think, to Brisbane than
it's technically called Brisvegas. But
yes, okay. You'll figure that out. I'll figure that out. I've only been here for a few hours.
Well, you obviously love Australia, and Darren, you might not know this about me, but I'm a bit of an investigative journalist, and I was doing some legal stalking of your social media, and I found a photo of you and Joe Jonas at a Penrith Panthers game, which looks like in Penrith.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's
what do you know about rugby league?
Absolutely bleep all what I know about. I'm actually so fascinated with just the construct of there's rugby, then there's footy, and there's different leagues that are the same but not.
Yes.
And it's so convoluted, and I'm fully here for it.
What did you think about it when you were there? Because I have to say, were there any reactions to you being in the crowd as well? Because, I mean, I go to the footy regularly, I'd be like,
the interest of my presence there, like, is negative amount. Like, it's not even zero. It's like the disinterest could not be further. But I was there with, like, Joe Jonas, and again, I think maybe some of the fans of that sport, maybe the demographics do not intersect with mine and Joe's. But I don't. Hey, I could be wrong. I don't know. I'm not saying anything. But from what I deduced, I think they were there for the Panthers.
Yeah. You didn't check out the Penrith Panthers Leagues Club while you were there.
We went to the locker room area.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And so we got kind of like the crazy cultural like chants and all their stuff.
Yeah.
That, that was awesome. But. I didn't get a damn thing. I have no idea what they were doing. It seemed very violent. I was worried for them.
They're in the finals again this year, so if they win, I'm putting it on you.
Yeah, go Panthers. Should I be very careful about saying that? Am I in good territory to say
you're
go Panthers?
Fine. No,
okay, cool.
You're good. So we obviously have a lot of fun here. When you're on tour, does it feel like work?
No, not at all. It does because, like I said, I'm in the service industry, and I want to make sure that the quality of experience is really high for other people. So if I make my quality of experience, which is drinking beers all day with my friends and my bandmates and my very good friends who have joined me, who are from the group that I started outside of college called Star Kid, which is one of the big things that was hugely popular with a lot of Australian fans. They're with me, so we're all just having a laugh, having a great time in Australia together. But I have to go, guys, I have to sing tonight. Yeah, so
you gotta go.
I gotta go. I'm showing like a half hour.
There are still a bunch of chances to catch Darren while he's in town. All the info's over at our website. Would you give it up for Darren Criss?
Yes. Thank you so much for having me.